I've seen a video where you saying that insulin, you don't recommend it to any of your clients. But I've also heard, obviously, that all bodybuilders off the record say that it's a necessity nowadays to take insulin. Oh, it's always been in order to be on that level.
Listen,
but also, one more thing. I also heard that it's very, very dangerous, and some people actually die from it. They take
it. I still till now, okay, I pray for forgiveness, because I was one of the few people to, you know, bless insulin at the beginning, you know what I'm saying? And give people the right, you know, way to do it. And, you know, and there is a right and wrong way. But the problem is, it's all wrong, man, when it comes to insulin. Because, you know what? Because, you know, I have to find out the wrong way. I mean, fortunately for me, I couldn't use insulin because of my shooting at the beginning. So I have like an IBS. And in order for you to use insulin, man, your stomach have to be perfect, because all that sugar and stuff you gotta take. You know, so I tried it. Oh my God, I end up on the toilet so many times, you know. I'm like, oh, I can't do it. I lose weight, you know. But honestly, man, the most important thing, you know, the hormone in your body is the insulin. If it's out of whack, everything's out of whack. Everything is out of whack. You know what we were talking at the beginning, you know, about like insulin. Like for an example, I had a friend, you know, a friend of mine, he came to me and he had blood pressure, you know. Now, a lot of people don't know that. You know, I'm telling you, I'm going into stuff because, man, I'm just like, you know, not because like I want to become a doctor, or not because my wife a doctor and we talk and stuff, but I'm trying to make it simple to these people. You know, like when you have your blood pressure, do you know what's, you know, like the upper means and what's the lower mean? Do you have any idea? Like
me, no,
120
no.
over 80. Do you know any idea?
I don't know.
A lot of people don't know. Okay.
People just go to a doctor and they hear if it's good or bad. You know what I mean?
Exactly. So the lower one is your heart. Like when it go, how much it pumps, that's the lower one. The upper one is what's going through your system, the blood, how fast it's going, you know what I'm saying? So 120 over 80, perfect. Now, if it's 140, 150, or whatever, and the bottom one is still 80, it's still okay. You know why? Because your body is trying to do something. There's something wrong with you. Something's wrong with your body, and that's why it's pushing that much, that blood, over 120, 30, 40, you know, instead of 120, the normal. Why is he doing this? Your body, your mechanism is doing this to help of whatever problem you have in, to fix it. So now you go to the doctor, what it does, it give you a pill. You go, oh my God, that doctor is amazing. He gave me the pill 2 days later, my blood pressure is perfect. Of course, you dummy, because you took a pill to, you know, to relax all this. But that's not mean it's good. You still have the problem. Yeah, you still have the problem. We didn't fix the problem. And we go back, like I said, at the beginning, we need to work on prevention, man. We need to work on prevention. Okay, why? You know, like if I go to a doctor and I have blood pressure, the first thing should be out of your mind, why do I have blood pressure? What do you mean you don't know? Well, there is a reason. Well, I tell you why. So we go back to the diet, that's why. Like my friend, you know what I did? I told him, okay, dude, what are you having? Well, I have this, this. I find out he's having a lot of sugar and a lot of sweets and a lot of stuff, you know. He's trying to get big or whatever. I said, dude, do me a favor, lower that stuff. I'm like, man, I'm your friend. You know what I mean? What are people going to say if something happened to you? They're going to think I gave you the diet. You know what I mean? So anyway, when I fix his diet and lower it, see, what happened is a lot of people don't understand. Sugar causes inflammation, okay? When it's inside your body, it causes inflammation to your artery and everything. So that's why your blood pressure go up, to fix those inflammation. You know. The same, you know, in how it fixes it, not the blood pressure is fixing it, but remember, like what I'm trying to tell you here, because it's really confusing. See, you don't have somebody who have blood pressure, you know, without cholesterol and without high sugar. They always come in three. Why? Because this is the main cause, is the sugar. So the sugar. Yeah, but the sugar is what causes, you know, blood pressure. Sugar, because of blood pressure, now you get damaged the artery. So the cholesterol come to fix your artery. So now you get blockage, and there you go, you have a problem, a heart attack or whatever, you know. You know, it's funny things because, you know, I'm reading and, you know, I'm always doing research and stuff. You know, not a lot of the people that have, you know, high cholesterol die from heart attack. Most people that died from heart attack, they never have cholesterol problem. You know what I'm saying? So it's weird. So that's why I tell people, man, stay away from sugar, because sugar is really the main cause, like we said at the beginning, the insulin. You know, and to give somebody insulin, for each unit, I was giving them like 15 grams of carb. So now if you take 10, 15 units, my God, you're up to 150 grams, 200 grams of carb at that one seat. Yeah, you're gonna get big, but your inside is suffering. You know what I'm saying? And now, if you have the genetic to get big, because a lot of people can take whatever they want. You know how many people, you see a guy, he takes all kind of stuff, he never changed. And then the guy barely look at stuff and he gets big. You see what I'm saying? Like when I tell people, you guys, Kai doesn't take much. They're like, yeah, right, yeah. Here, look, no way. I'm like, yes way. You know? You know what I'm trying to say? People think it's the more, the better. It's not, man. It's the nutrition. And it's like, I said it before. You know, like the ladies, they wore a necklace in there. You know, if it's one link missing, there's no necklace, right? If there's one, and that's how bodybuilding. If you don't train, and you don't eat good, and you don't sleep good, and you have hydration, you're not gonna have that necklace. You're not gonna be a bodybuilder. You're not gonna be bodybuilders. People think they just, oh, you know, I'll just take some GH and some testosterone and DECA and this, oh, I'm gonna get big. No, dude, no. This is the problem with those stupid little kids. They're ruining the game we all love. Because now the average Joe outside think, oh, you're a muscle head. Yeah, he's taking a lot of steroids, that's why. Dude, why don't you come take the same steroids? Let me see what's gonna happen to you. You know what's gonna happen? Nothing. You're gonna stay still the same. Because they're sacrificing, man, for bodybuilding. Bodybuilding, it's the worst. It's probably the hardest freaking, you know, sport you can play. You know what I'm saying? Your food have to be perfect. Your sleep have to be perfect. Your water have to, you know, everything. Your vitamins, everything. Like you can, like I know people, they take so many things and they come to me, they say, I can't grow. And I look at, I'm like, okay, get me a blood work, get me blood work. I look, oh my God, your D, your B is off, your vitamins. Dude, how are you gonna grow if you know, the least, like people, they take all the steroid and everything and they forget about taking multivitamin, for example, a mineral. Well, guess what? This is what's gonna help you. You know what I'm saying? They're a little thing. You know, so they, you know, a lot of people, they have the wrong knowledge about stuff, man, due to those little idiots around. You know, like, oh, take this, I take that. No, dude, it's not about taking this and taking that. It's about do it smart. You wanna take steroid? Get a blood work done. Get somebody who knows what he's doing. Don't just take it, you know, like maliciously, like it's nothing. Dude, that's your body. Like I said, I keep going on this because I wanna drill it in people's head. There is life after bodybuilding.